he wanted to learn how to play piano, and I was the only one he knew that had one. So he would come over, play the piano, and blow on this harmonica, which he had just gotten and was trying to learn. He bought a harmonica holder, got me to go to Schmidt's music department to get him a harmonica holder. And so he would sit and badly play on the piano and badly play on the harmonica in my sorority house. And my sorority sisters thought it was a riot. And I remember one time they called up the guys in the fraternity behind us who were the Phi Delta Thetas and says, "You won't believe this weird scene that's going on." So the Phi Deltas came over and the Thetas were standing around and just making fun of him. And I was just burning because I loved this guy, you know, and I was burning with a self-righteous passion that I wanted him to do for them what I knew he was capable of, which was give a good performance. And he didn't give a shit about doing a good performance. He was trying to learn to play two new instruments at once. And he didn't care that they were making fun of him. But I remember sitting there and trying to convince him, please play Slipknot, play, you know, the various numbers that he was doing then that I knew sounded good. And I wanted him to play the guitar, which he could play well, and which would impress him. And he just wasn't having any of it. And it's been one of the big lessons in my life, remembering that, because he just didn't give a shit what anyone thought. He was going for what he wanted to learn, period. And, of course, he became a great genius.